Spider-Man 2 was directed by Sam Raimi and it was released in 2004. Now, this movie, above anything, is about personal responsibility. Peter Parker remembers his Uncle Ben's famous words of great power comes great responsibility. And as such, Peter does his best to balance the dual life of being Spider-Man and Peter Parker. Spider-Man is really busy saving all the citizens from any and all danger. And as such, Peter has less time to be there for Mary Jane and to go see her show. He has less time to go to school and to do well. And last but not least, he has less time to actually go to work and do his job well. And as such, Peter loses his job early on in the movie because the pizza delivery was indeed late. Peter does struggle a lot in this movie, and as a viewer, I really felt it. And honestly, it was done very well. There's a scene in which Peter is talking to Uncle Ben, and we get a glimpse as to who they really are as people. Uncle Ben was such a good man who believed in justice, who believed in doing what was right. Peter, I could tell, really loves Uncle Ben and really wanted to carry on his dream of justice and just being what Uncle Ben could unfortunately never be. And later on in the scene, with tears in his eyes, he says, "No, Uncle Ben, I'm just Peter Parker. I'm Spider-Man no more. No more." And honestly, the interaction between Uncle Ben and Peter was really well done. And frankly, I miss Uncle Ben. This scene really makes me wish he was around more. Cliff Robertson was a great actor, and Toby was great in this as well. So Peter Parker gives up being Spider-Man. Hooray? I think so. I mean, you have a nice happy song, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, and it's a great montage, and here we see Peter with glasses, and he's happy for once. Life is going great for him, and then we get the universe telling him basically that he can't stop being Spider-Man. What happens is that a guy gets mugged in an alley and Peter's horrified. He wants to help him, but he can't because he's just Peter Parker now. He can't do it anymore. So he walks away and he feels bad, of course. And also, there's a burning building later on, or maybe beforehand, I forgot when. But there's a burning building and Peter Parker goes inside. He saves the little girl, which is all fine and good, but unfortunately, there was a guy in the upper level and he died. Peter feels bad about this because he knew that if he were Spider-Man, he could have saved them both. But unfortunately, that wasn't the case, and Peter really contemplates what he should do. I love Peter's interaction with Aunt May, Harry Osborn, and Mary Jane Watson, and for different reasons. Aunt May, for example, he loves her and respects her so very much. And I remember early on in the movie, she gives him $20 for his birthday. And he says, "I can't take this." And she says, "Yes, you can take it." And she breaks down and tells him sorry, and that she missed Uncle Ben. And I can hear the heartbreak in her voice. And frankly, it's hard to watch, but still a great scene. Later on, Peter, after feeling so guilty about Uncle Ben's death, tells him the truth, and Aunt May is shocked. She has her hand on the table, and Peter tries to cover her. So she just pulls away. She stares at him, gets up, walks away, and never says a word. She proved that you can say everything without saying anything. Later on, Aunt May says that she forgives Peter and tells him thank you for telling her the truth. And then she gives her famous speech about our hero and all of us and inspirational music, Peter's reaction, the love and the respect. It really drove it home. It was a great speech and a great scene. Harry Osborn is still a good guy in the beginning of the movie. He is still relatively close to Peter Parker, and he even offers Peter a chance to endorse Dr. Otto Octavius. But whenever Harry thinks about Spider-Man, he becomes evil and just overall against the world in a way. Peter Parker, because of his dual life, is put in a really bad situation because Spider-Man killed his father, Norman Osborn, aka the Green Goblin. Harry asks him a question, and that is, if you knew who he was, what do you tell me? And Peter just didn't know what to do. He was basically like, can we drop it? I want to be friends again. And this is interesting because it shows that Peter and Harry want different things. Harry wants revenge for his father's death, and Peter wants to be friends again. This leads to Harry later on in the movie getting mad at Peter, and he slaps him a few times. And later on, Harry unmasks Spider-Man, and then he finds out that, to his horror, Peter is the murderer of his father. This leads to Spider-Man 3, which I will not review. Mary Jane Watson is the girl of Peter Parker's dreams, and he really wants to be with her. But because he's Spider-Man, he can't. He's too busy, and frankly, he's just too dangerous. But later on, when he stops being Spider-Man, he is then able to go to her plays. He's able to try to woo her with poetry. And overall, he can't be with her because he isn't along with Spider-Man. And as such, they can't be together. But then she has a fiancé named John James, which puts everything on hold. And it puts everyone in a predicament. But overall, I like the interaction between them because Peter shows that he really does want to change. Mary Jane shows gratitude towards Peter, who's also her friend. And frankly, I enjoy the fact that he has a goal in mind, and that is to try to win the girl of his dreams. I will add J. Jonah Jameson because he was amazing. J.K. Simmons was perfect as him. From the look, to the way he acts, yelling constantly, the way he talks to Peter Parker, to Betty Brant, to Robbie, his view of Spider-Man, and frankly, he was so entertaining. But the cool thing about Jameson is that he has a humanity about him. In the movie, he has a scene in which he admits that Spider-Man could have saved the day, but it was his fault that he was gone. He drove him away. And they have a moment of silence. And then Spider-Man gets his costume back. And then the feud comes back. J. Jonah Jameson will get that masked menace someday. Peter Parker is a mild-mannered protagonist that people can relate to. Whether it be his struggles with work, or his struggles with school, or paying his rent, or with his love life, or lack thereof, or his friends. You name it, Peter has it pretty rough constantly. But despite all that, Peter is still a good guy. He's there for his family and his friends as best as he can be. And above anything, he believes in justice and helping out other people. Like when he helped out that little girl in the burning building, or when he went to rescue Mary Jane, or when he helped the people on the train. Honestly, Peter is such a great character. I've always been a fan of him, and frankly, I love the way he is in this movie. The antagonist is Dr. Octopus, aka Dr. Octavius. Now, when I first saw him on a poster, I thought to myself, is he going to be a good villain? I don't know. I mean, I've never been too big on Dr. Octopus, so I really wasn't sure. But when I saw the movie in 2013, I thought to myself, wow, he's actually really, really good. Maybe even great. Octavius was a good, humble, brilliant man who was happily married to a woman named Rosie. He even gave Peter the pointer about the poetry. But unfortunately, tragedy strikes at Oscorp. In the experiment, Rosie unfortunately dies, and Dr. Otto Octavius has the arms put on his body forever. And this makes him go crazy, and later on he does things that he wouldn't normally do, such as rob a bank, try to kidnap Aunt May, kidnapped Mary Jane and tried to destroy New York in his experiment. But later on in the movie, Peter inspires him with what he told him about science being used for the benefit of humanity. And also he gave Otto part of Aunt May's famous speech, and this inspired him. He sacrificed himself. He went down with his machine. He redeemed himself. He died a hero, but all in all, he died a great character. The fight scenes are really, really fun to watch. I love watching him fight because he's very acrobatic, he's very agile, he's very quick, and also he's very creative. I love the fight scenes because of that. Like in the bank fight, in which Octopus throws money bags at him. He dodges them all, but grabs them with the web and throws it right back at him. Well, how about at the clock tower? They're fighting alongside the clock tower. Spider-Man gets knocked down. He grabs a clock out with his web and throws it right back at him. Or how about when they're fighting, when they're falling down? That's also really cool. And last but not least, the train fight. I love the way Spider-Man maneuvers inside the train. I love the way he dodges Dr. Octopus and his tentacles. It's all really, really cool. And honestly, another high for me. Before I get my final thoughts, I want to give you guys a look at the actual DVD. Front cover, back cover, inside, and of course, the bonus features. Here's the front cover. Nice shot of Spider-Man and Mary Jane. Back cover. Here's the inside. A nice looking disc. And the bonus features are as follows. Disc 1, commentary with director Sam Raimi, Tobey Maguire, producer Avi Arad, and co-producer Grant Curtis. Technical commentary, blooper reel, Spidey Sense 2, which is a trivia track, 4 webisodes, train ordinary music video, previews, and disc 2. Making the Amazing, a 12-part documentary from pre-production to the Hollywood premiere. Hero in Crisis, a deeper look into Peter Parker and his personal battles in the continuing story of Spider-Man. Occumentary, 8 Arms to Hold You, a special look at Doc Ock from the comics to the big screen. Interwoven, The Women of Spider-Man, a look into the lives of Mary Jane, Aunt May, and the other women. Enter the Web, a groundbreaking multi-angle look behind the scenes at the climatic pier sequence captured in real time. Art Gallery, Activision's Spider-Man 2, Spinning the Game, a behind the scenes look at the making of the game, and Web Links. When I first saw this movie in 2004, I didn't get it, I will admit that. But then when I saw it in 2013, I finally understood. I finally had a great time with the movie. Peter Parker is very likable. He's very relatable. His struggle was all over the place, and it was hard to watch. But at the same time, it made me feel invested in Peter Parker. I wanted him to be happy. I wanted him to succeed. I wanted him to get the girl, and he did. Great cast, very talented individuals. I love seeing Peter's interaction with Aunt May, Harry Osborn, Mary Jane, Dr. Otto Octavius, and of course, J. Jonah Jameson. I loved the fight scenes. I loved Spider-Man swinging. I loved the whole thing about responsibility. A great cameo from Uncle Ben. And last but not least, I loved the ending song done by Dashboard Confessional. Comment down below, tell me your thoughts on the movie, on my video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for the support. Take care, guys.